Michelle Knight, and this is the astrological update for Aries for the whole of May. Now this May, it's all about your personal finances, adventure, and fundamentally it's all about communication. You want to get your ideas out into the world this May. You want to spread something and sow the seeds of what you want to create. It all kicks off when Mercury enters your position of finances and you're determined to ground yourself. You may have felt yourself a little bit carried away by passion, enthusiasm, and kind of airy-fairy ideas, which is quite unlike you. But now you're determined to lay some solid foundations, and the things that you commit to this month are incredibly important because you mean it, or other people are going to make you stick to it. So be very, very careful about what exactly you're saying and to whom. We have Mars and Mercury conjunction at the beginning of May, which is again encouraging you to really passionately grasp your dreams, go after what you want career-wise. Nothing and no one can hold you back. Careful not to lose your temper at work though, because you are feeling so fueled with passion, you might end up putting your foot down or being stubborn in the wrong place. We then have Venus, the planet of love, on the 9th, entering your position of communication. Now, around this time of year, you're very good at articulating yourself, particularly when it comes to relationships. You're able to speak very, very clearly without being emotional, hopefully, and you're able to discuss what you want. You're also able, if you turn that energy inwards, to find out a lot more about yourself and your love journey. It's a great time to keep a journal or write down a history of your relationships, although if you're a typical Aries, that may take you some time, and look for any patterns, and look for patterns within you that you can transform. For the past few months, you should have been going through a revolution in the way you see your relationship to others and yourself, and this Venus is going to encourage you to continue on that journey by going within and looking at who you are when it comes to love. We then have a new moon on the 10th and a solar eclipse. This is very powerful times. It's a transformation when it comes to your sense of security in the world and who you are in the world and how you feel with your feet on the ground in the world. And it also gives you the opportunity to allow you to see yourself differently, particularly when it comes to finance. Now, Mercury, the planet of communication, goes into your position of communication on the 15th. And that's when you're able to really get your ideas out there. If you write a blog or you do anything that involves people listening to your words, it's the perfect time to really communicate clearly. Trouble is, you might find yourself a little bit overwhelmed by communication also towards the last 2 weeks of this month, with everybody wanting your opinion, everybody wanting to talk to you, and you like, whew, important that you take some space around that time. Now there's a Mercury and Venus conjunction, and it's also sextiling Uranus, so something unexpected communication in your relationships. And also, you've got to make a decision about how your spiritual beliefs are affecting your relationships, or are they impacting your relationships enough, or are you doing something within yourself that goes against your own grain? Be open with yourself. We have a fabulous full super moon on the 25th, and that's urging you to expand, to be impulsive, to learn something, to maybe take up something that you've been meaning to study or grasp or explore. And really, it is all about exploration and adventure. You may have a peak emotional experience. You might do something kind of outrageous on that day, but be a little bit careful because you might also be feeling a little bit emotionally reckless. We end the month on the 28th with a Venus and Jupiter conjunct, and it's saying to you, spread the word of love in the world. Be love in the world. Love yourself, love others. Embrace all the people around you with an open heart. And actually, it's a great time for you to tell the people in your life that you love how they've transformed your life, how you value them, and give them a positive boost. That's something you're good at, but it really re-energizes you and rebonds you to the people in your life. Mercury on the 31st and Mars go into a position where you're thinking more about your home and your family, and you're feeling very sensitive. But more about that next month. I send you much love, and I'll speak to you soon.